When you consider a system of linear ODEs with constant coefficients, like this one, we have seen that the qualitative behavior is characterized by the eigenvalues of matrix A. Since the eigenvalues can be complex, let us use the complex plane to visualize them. For instance, if you have two negative eigenvalues, and eigenvector directions like this one, the dynamics might look like this. With the same eigenvalues but different eigenvectors, the field might look quite different. But in both cases, we have a stable fixed point in the center, which is called a node. If we simply flip the sign of the eigenvalues, but we keep the eigenvectors, we have seen that the flow of the dynamics simply inverts. Again, the origin is a node, but in this case, an unstable one. If we have a positive and negative eigenvalue, we get a saddle point. If one eigenvalue is zero, then we have one dimension in which the dynamics is indifferent, and in this case, with a negative eigenvalue, the system would simply converge onto this indifferent dimension. If you have complex eigenvalues, we have seen that they always come in complex conjugate pairs. The dynamics then contains also a rotational component, and the time that it takes for full rotation is determined by the imaginary part. A large imaginary part would mean a fast rotation, and a small imaginary part would be slow rotation, until in the end, if the imaginary part vanishes completely and you have two real eigenvalues, there is no rotational component anymore. I say the imaginary part determines the time that it takes for full rotation because, due to distortions, the trajectory might form an ellipse and then there is no constant angular velocity. The real part indicates, as before, whether the dynamics decays towards the origin or grows away from the origin, expands. In this case, because we have a negative real value, we would have a decay towards the origin. And that means we would have a spiral towards the origin. The direction of rotation depends on the eigenvectors. This example that I've shown is rather circular. If the real and imaginary part of the eigenvectors, which also come in complex conjugate pairs, have different length or are not orthogonal to each other, then we would get spirals. Again, if we flip the sign of the eigenvalues, the dynamics inverts. If the real part is zero, we get strict circles or ellipses. If instead the imaginary part is zero and the real parts are identical, then we get a completely symmetric node. And if imaginary as well as real part is zero, then there's neither growth nor decay in any direction, and we get Lyapunov stable fixed points everywhere. No matter where you start, the system just stays there. Having all this in mind, we can now interpret more complicated cases, i.e. high-dimensional cases. This system, for instance, has 8 dimensions, so it's an 8-dimensional system, It has two dimensions indicated here by the two red dots, which have negative eigenvalues, so therefore the system decays in these directions. Then with the light blue eigenvalues, we have a rotation that neither spirals in or out, so it's a constant rotation on a circle or an ellipse. The green eigenvalues indicate a spiral out, so it's a rotation, but with a positive real values, that means it's spiraling out, it's growing. And the pink one is not rotating, but it's growing even faster than the green one. The green rotation is slower than the blue one. And in the middle, we also see a gray eigenvalue, which is zero, indicating one dimension in which the system is completely indifferent. So this is not stable, has two rotations, one expansion, two decaying dimensions, and one indifferent dimension. It is also interesting to imagine a changing system. So imagine we start with this two-dimensional system. We know it rotates because it has a complex conjugate pair of eigenvalues, and it grows because the real part is positive. Now imagine that the eigenvalues change over time in this way, where the two trajectories are meant to be completely symmetric. So what would that mean for the system? Well, we have said it starts with a spiraling out because of the positive real part. And as it traverses here this trajectory, we see the rotation gets first faster, since the imaginary part gets larger, and then slower again, while the growth slows down because the real part gets smaller and smaller until it is zero. In that case, we only have a rotation. And then as the real part gets negative, the dynamic spirals in until it will eventually converge to the origin. And we also see, since the imaginary part gets smaller again, that the rotation gets slower and slower. Imagine now that you have a system that starts with the green eigenvalues, and you want to change it into a system with the red eigenvalues. So we know initially it will be a spiraling out, and then it will be a saddle point with one positive and one negative eigenvalue, so one dimension will expand and the other one will decay. So now, what is a possible trajectory for the eigenvalues? Now, we know that complex eigenvalues can only appear in complex conjugate pairs. So as long as there is an imaginary part, the values have to be symmetric. Thus, a possible trajectory would be like this. So first, the two eigenvalues move completely symmetrically to the left and closer to the real axis. Once they meet and the imaginary part is zero, they are free to now move in different directions. But only then. So this concrete trajectory would now correspond to a system which first spirals out, then as the eigenvalues move towards left, the growth gets slower and slower. Also, the rotation velocity slows down a bit. Then, as the real part gets negative, the spiral goes inwards. And now also the rotation velocity slows down quite a bit. Until at the point where they meet, they form a symmetric node, in this case a stable one. And then one dimension decays slower and slower, that's the one that goes to the right, until it starts growing. And the other dimension decays even faster. So when the eigenvalues meet on the real axis, the whole system is stable because all real eigenvalues are negative. But then it becomes unstable again as the light green eigenvalue or trajectory crosses the imaginary axis. So as you see here, The qualitative behavior of a system of linear ODEs with constant coefficients can be easily analyzed based on the eigenvalues. You don't need to know anything about the eigenvectors, about the details of the dynamics. Just knowing the eigenvalues tells you all the qualitative behavior of the system. And this is even true if the matrix does not have a full set of eigenvectors. So in that case, still the stability is determined by the eigenvalues. By the way, as soon as we imagine the eigenvalues moving around like this one here in the middle and the right graph, the coefficients of the system cannot be constant anymore. They have to change because the matrix changes to make the eigenvalues change. But here I've assumed that the constants change slowly compared to the dynamics of the system so that we can use still use the analysis from the constant coefficients. Actually, even if the coefficients would change rapidly, the dynamics in every given moment, of course, would be determined by the analysis that we have derived here. But the intuitive interpretation might not be as straightforward anymore.